It's time for voting time, okay? Everyone, please vote using the lever in front of you! But I guess we already know who the blackened is, don't we?
Good job, you got it right. Brilliantly right. We got it right? Does that mean Kyoka really is the killer? But something strange is going on here. Something wrong with this whole class trial. Kyoko!
Now then, I prepared a very special punishment.
Is everyone ready? Okay then.
Let's give it everything we've got. It's punishment time!
Did we really all just vote for Kyoko? That's how the class trial Mukuro Ikusaba came to an end? I still had to wonder whether Kyoko was actually innocent or... God, this truth was lost forever, even for me? I just stopped thinking about it? That was the end of Mukuro's class trial? And in the end, it would prove to be our last class trial. Once that case was over, there was never a single murder at Hope's Peak ever again? We had attained peace in exchange for the lives of all the others? What happened to Toko? Why did I get the end with Hiro? Why did everyone bang Hina? Peace, but only for us? That was the only hope he had? Hope? This is hope.
No! This isn't right!
Good! Okay. Huh?
Makoto, why are you staring off into space? Don't you have a rebuttal for Kyoko's claim?
Oh! This game! my god. Oh. Proclaim? Oh, that's right. I had to. Do I smoke Yo's lie or not? So you all know I was going to pursue the lie, right? Like, I was doing that intentionally. Okay. She's not wrong. I have to think about this very carefully. What do? Let it go. I've made my decision. I have to believe in Kyoko. There's no way she would kill someone. There has to be some secret here, something that has to do with the mastermind strap that Kyoko meshed.
Well, does no one have a rebuttal? Have you decided to accept her assertion as fact? I see. So you still refuse to accept it. I suppose we have to admit that Kyoko didn't put the locker key in her room, that it was someone else.
But who else could it have been?
I mean, Byakuya had a room key, right?
You! What are you trying to imply?
But of course I have an alibi. From nighttime on, I was with you guys the entire time. I couldn't possibly have killed anyone, or put the key in Kyoko's room.
Well, someone had to put the key in there.
There's only one other possibility I can think of.
Monokuma. Which, if we vote, can we vote for Monokuma? And if we can, does the robot get the execution or the mastermind behind the robot?
Someone could have had the key on them, then once they arrived at the scene, pretended to find it there.
It's so basically Toko blew up. Maybe when she saw Togami tapping that Hina booty, her mind couldn't handle it and she just spontaneously skimbusted.
What? It had to be Makoto, right?
I don't see any other option.
Wait a second. You've got it all wrong. Let's think about it one more time. There's gotta be a hidden side to this case.
Huh? A hidden side?
First of all, there's something off about this entire trial. You all see it, don't you? Mukuro, who we didn't even know existed, suddenly shows up dead, and then we're thrown into a trial. And Kyoko even said, it's a trap the mastermind set for us. So that's why this has to be...
Okay, time's up!
Huh?
Time's up! Class trial's all over! Everyone can stop talking now!
What? Time's up?
What do you mean, time's up? There's no time's up. Since when have we...
It's because you were late, so we had to push back the start time! So then, it's time for voting time, okay? Everyone, please vote using the lever in front of you!
Voting time?
Well, I vote for Monokuma. I feel like that would be accurate, chat. Which would explain Toko's explosion. Super. Yeah.
Now, who will be chosen as the Blackened? Will you make the right choice or the dreadfully wrong one?
Apparently Bean said she just exploded. So yeah, spontaneous combustion over the fact that Togami was tapping that Hina.
Hey, hold on. What's it gonna be? What's it gonna be?
What? You think I'm the killer?
Sorry, man.
Sorry.
Yeah, sorry. Wait! Why me? Why is it always me? It was all your fault. Everyone, you're wrong. You got it all wrong. I didn't do it.
Yes, indeed.
Good job, everyone.
Good job.
Yep.
Yeah, they got it right.
No, I know that's not true. None of this makes any sense. The whole trial doesn't make any sense.
Hey.
It makes perfect sense.
Shing.
It's the same as always. It's just like all the other class trials, and I'm gonna end it the same way.
Thrills, chills, kills.
It's time for your heart-pounding, positively thrilling punishment.
Wait, why do I... Kyoko!
I don't expect you to forgive me. I know this is all my fault.
Wait, I gotta die? Kyoko?
Let's give it everything we've got! It's punishment time!
Shit! Fight back! Fight back! You broke it! Monokuma just totally killed me! Makoto, you're not gonna sit there and take it, are you? You're just gonna take it. Get up and walk away. Fight back.
I'm coming for you. I'm coming for you. Oh, I'm coming for you.
So why did this happen for Kyoko? I have no idea.
What's this? What's going on?
Hey, what was that?
Yeah, it had to be.
This is
alter ego.
Alter ego? Is this some stupid virus from that stupid guy? He must have planted it when he invaded my network. Damn it all to hell, I don't believe this.
It would seem...
Seems you finally made a miscalculation. No, you miscalculated from the very beginning.
What the heck?
What was that?
In other words...
What I'm saying is, you shouldn't have underestimated us.
Why are you talking like that? You've already won. I barely felt a thing. It was a pinch, an itch. The stupid virus is gone now, got it? And so is Makoto. Maybe I didn't get to smash him, but you never gotta see him again.
Yeah-ha!
To waste away in the garbage strewn pits in a way that's an even better special punishment. But it's still not enough. I'm still not satisfied. I'm so gonna bring despair to the rest of you. Bring despair to the entire world.
Is he gone? Kyoko, what's the meaning of all this? So what the hell is going on?
Calm down.
It's okay. We're not the ones being trapped this time.
In other words...
Now that it's the mastermind that's ensnared.
What
are you talking about?
So...
You'll understand soon enough. Very soon indeed. The massive high school towers, all... Oh, wait! Makoto! Massive high school towers over all of the other buildings in this bustling urban area. It's like the school stands at the center of the entire world. Speak Academy. It brings in top students from every field imaginable. What is going on? A government-funded school of privilege. They say that if you come here and manage to graduate, you'll be set for life. With hundreds of years of tradition, it sends the cream of the crop into the workforce every year. It was built to raise hope in the nation's future, which makes Hope Peak a pretty fitting name. There are two things you need to attend to school. One, you have to already be attending high school, and two, you have to be the very best at what you do. No ordinary school student enroll here. The only way in is if you get scouted by the school itself. And standing there at the gate of the ultimate school with the ultimate students was me. What is going on? Ah, sorry. What?
What? Where am I?
I woke up with my head resting on top of a hard wooden desk. Body felt heavy. It wouldn't be weird for me to zonk off in the middle of some boring class or whatever, but what was I doing asleep just now? It wasn't any classroom I'd ever been in before. What the heck's going on?
Yeah.
Finally. I could finally feel my mind and body start to come back together again, and then I was awake. Or was this just another dream? A dream inside a hopeless nightmare? No, this isn't a dream. I could tell because the stench invading my nostrils was too powerful for a dream. What an awful smell. It was in a vast, dark cavern with the barest of light seeping in. Dressers piled high across all the area. This must be some kind of underground garbage pit? Heck of a situation to find myself in. It was just the beginning of my problems. Was I going to be stuck in there until I wasted away and died? No, I can't let that happen. Not after what my good friend went through to save me. I remembered all too well what happened. Alter ego like a boss. Used up the last little bit of his strength to do it. So I can't give up now. For myself and for my friend. That my pursuit of survival began. First, it was up to start looking for a way out of here. Is that an airplane? Did something like that wind in the school's garbage pit? This is a desk. Probably the one that fell down here with me. And that looks like a rocket and a tank. Wait, that's the rocket from the beginning of the game. What is going on? I better not think too much about what I'm seeing down here, because it's insanity. It's locked. No matter how many times I pushed or pulled or kicked at it, it didn't budge. Getting out of here isn't going to be easy. Well, if I'm not getting out of here anytime soon, I decided to look around for some food. There's plenty of food here, but it's all rotten. Oh, but that was pointless too. Next, I searched for some water. How can I be sure which liquids I can drink? Which ones are all around bad idea? And pointless. I feel like I'm blocked on all sides. It's not still enough to reason to give up because I'm still alive. As long as I'm alive, I'll never give up. Yeah. After making that proud declaration, next thing I decided to do was jumping jacks. Go to sleep. My sleep was deep and uninterrupted. It was my only way to preserve what little strength I had left, not after not being able to eat or drink. I can't be sure, but I think at least a full day had passed. And all I did was sleep and sleep. It was like I was waiting for some kind of sign to come falling out of the sky. However, what fell from the sky wasn't a sign. Not exactly. What the? Strange sound pierced my silent isolation, drawing me awake. As I watched, the pile of garbage jostled and formed an odd shape. Did something fall down over there? Something fell from above. What could it have been? Did a giant piece of trash just fall down here? I definitely stretched my hand out toward whatever it was that had tumbled down here with me.
Just a second.
A giant piece of trash. Rude. Before she even emerged from the pile of garbage, I knew who it was.
It smells awful.
Okay. Kyoko!
Indeed.
You look like you're doing better than I expected. What are you doing down here? Isn't it obvious? I'm here to help you. I'm glad to hear that, Kyoko, but, you gotta go. I'm just gonna go ahead and grab that. You got a little bit of garbage. I'm just gonna, there we go. Okay, you're fine. You might wanna, She gave her head a quick sharp shake to get rid of the trash, then faced me again.
Hey.
First, I have something for you. Go ahead and eat it. We can talk when you once you're finished. Oh my god, food! Biscuits! Snatched some bread and water that she was holding out for me. Within seconds, it was in my mouth and making it way toward my stomach. Whew, I really hit the spot. Now I've got the energy I need to keep going. But you still haven't given up then. Of course not. After all, I mean, the fact that I can keep going for it is all I'm good for, right? Well, that's not just such a bad thing to be good at. I am the ultimate persistent asshole. And or good boy. But Kyoko, why'd you come to rescue me?
So...
to pay a debt. Or, no, to atone. Atone?
You...
during the trial, even though you knew I was lying, you didn't say anything. So you knew that I knew.
Indeed.
But even though I knew, I did nothing to help you.
I...
abandoned you. Don't say that. You didn't abandon me. You threw me under the bus, and then you backed up, and you ran me over 3 times. But you didn't abandon me. No, you... No, that's exactly what I did. I abandoned you in order to save my own life. You were trying to save me, and I couldn't bring myself to do the same for you.
However,
but listen, not that I'm trying to make excuses, but there was a reason that I had to survive. Why did you have to survive?
It's true.
I'll tell you everything. The reason I had to survive,
in other words,
is so that I can do what I came to the school to do. I am a higher hitman. I need to take out the bad guy. I made up my mind to come up to the Hope Speak Academy for one very important reason.
Indeed.
At least I did once.
I...
until recently, I'd forgotten what it was. You forgot? But that's... wait! You forgot? And you went on a hunch? I had no memory of what my purpose was. It's impossible. Amnesia? Then, is it really true you lost your memory?
Makoto.
Do you remember Makoto? Do you remember the first thing that happened to each of us as soon as we arrived at the school? First thing... I remember getting conked out. You're talking about when we fainted, right? I fainted, and when I woke up, I was trapped here.
That's right.
Two, and when I woke up, I noticed a strange feeling of separation within myself. Whoa! Kitsune, not 600 seconds. You want to correct that. A disconnect.
It would seem...
back on it now. Also, what had been, like... did I miss something? At that point, my memory was gone. At that time, I'd forgotten. I couldn't remember why I'd come to this school, and I couldn't remember why... what my ultimate... ability was. But what would make you forget all that?
Hey.
Strange, isn't it? It's hard to imagine it happened by chance. We'll get to the anime. We'll get to the anime eventually. But when it comes to story spoilers with the anime or anything down the road, please abstain from it. That way, when we do get to it, it'll be a treat. Seems much too convenient. Are you saying you think you lost your memory because... I don't think, I'm positive that it was the work of the mastermind. They stole my memory. But... yeah, why is the default set to 600, by the way? Why would they want to do that? My understanding is anything that happens in the anime will happen in Danganronpa 3. Like, it's all connected, right? Like, all the story is interweaved. There's only one reason I can come up with. Because of my purpose and my abilities, somehow they would interfere with the Mastermind's plans. So the Mastermind just stole them from you?
However,
and it could also mean somehow my memories may be connected to the mystery of the school and the Mastermind, which is why I have to get them back. That's why I've been investigating things by myself this whole time. But what if you say it's true? Why didn't you ask the rest of us to help you?
Why is that?
If I did that and we all worked as one, the Mastermind wouldn't have noticed right away. Plus, there's always a chance that the Mastermind is actually one of us. Okay. What?
Correct.
Well, don't make too big of a deal of it. It's just a possibility. But since it is a possibility, we can't ignore it, right? Mastermind, one of us. If she believed that, then of course she couldn't trust anyone around her. In which case, it only makes sense that she would look into her missing memory by herself.
However,
that being said, there was a limit to what I could do by myself, which is why I asked you to help me. But why me? Because among everyone, you were least likely to be the Mastermind. That was just intuition. But basically, you're so average, you can't fake it. You can fake being dumb, apparently. You just can't fake being average. I see. Your intuition was right, though. There's no way an ordinary kid like me could have been the Mastermind.
I understand. I should understand everything. My goal isn't to get out of here. It's to stay here.
How does that wrap around? It's just like that dream I had before, but why did that just happen?
Listen.
Are you okay? Oh, yeah, it's nothing. It is nothing, right? How about you just say it? I mean, you guys can trust each other now, so... Makoto, spill it.
Hey.
Even now, I still trust you, you know. It's just, I'm not used to relying on others.
Correct.
I know I never asked you for help the right way, so I understand if you're not convinced. Honestly, I was convinced. I think it's just her personality. She's just, you know, blunt like a weapon. You said you had a reason for doing all that investigating on your own. So how'd that turn out? Were you able to remember anything?
So,
I think there's still a lot I don't remember, but at the very least, I was finally able to recall my purpose. Okay. You mentioned your ability. My ability, whatever everyone should have known me for. What? Oh my god, the surprise! Ultimate detective.
Correct.
The reason I came to Hope Speak Academy, there was someone I had to find here.
So,
well, it was the headmaster of Hope Speak Academy. Why did you want to find the headmaster? Because he's my father.
Ah, so hold on. If memory is removed,
we know that Junko is the Mastermind because somebody spoiled it. Does that mean that Junko's her older sister?
In other words,
I was separated from him as a child. As it turns out, he became the headmaster of Host Peak. Then that explains it. When Alter Ego told us how he thought the headmaster was involved. I'll find a way.
Huh?
Huh?
I,
no matter what it takes, I'll find the headmaster.
What?
At the cost.
So,
Yoko, what's going on? My memory hadn't come back at that point. But when he said, "All right, Cinder, you take it easy, buddy." It felt strange. It makes perfect sense now. Of course, since my whole purpose for coming here was to find him.
However,
makes sense. But listen, Makoto, I want to make this perfectly clear so there's no misunderstanding. I said the headmaster wasn't the Mastermind, but I didn't say